Many people claim their thing is under assault by culture, but yo, this might actually be true for science. Hey there, friends who love science, or other people who may hate it. My name is Trace Dominguez. This is D News. It's a science show. Just FYI. Cool. Yes, I know science isn't literally under attack. Not really. I mean, earlier this year, the former Secretary of Justice of the United Kingdom did say, quote, "People in this country have had enough of experts." And at the time that we filmed this video, the possible head of the EPA here in the US has called climate change policy one of many pretexts for expanding government and called global warming phony and not based in science. Plus, the vice president-elect called climate change a myth and a theory, and the president-elect said it is not caused by humans, though it may be a hoax perpetrated by China, where humans live, so someone's gonna have to figure out how that vogues. Maybe we should call in some extra experts. Maybe the UK has some out there. Meanwhile, according to multiple reviews of the scientific literature, 97% of publishing scientists who study it say climate change, global warming is real. It's happening now, and we need to do something about it. The sea levels are rising, and the 16 warmest years since 1880 have all been in the 18 years since 1998, with most of that temperature increase happening since 1970. The science is settled. There's a lot of evidence, and yet people don't believe it. We're sitting in a metaphorical car sinking in a river and debating how we got off the road and whether cars float. It doesn't matter. We need to do something about this other thing right now. Why don't people believe evidence? A 2015 study in the Annals of the American Academy of Political and Social Science explores that exact question. But before we look at that study, let's back up a little bit more broadly. A study in Public Opinion Quarterly points out politicizing something like nuclear power at all renders arguments about the environmental benefits invalid, even if there's a consensus. Basically, when something is politicized, we tend to react emotionally and stick to the status quo because change is scary. So knowing that, let's go back to this new study about why we hate evidence so much. Researchers created a model of human cognition to see why people don't believe evidence, even when it is right in front of them. They believe, essentially, we have a problem separating our emotion from our decision-making. Political opinions and ideologies are part of those emotions. Let's say I'm asking you about global warming. According to their model and other research they cite, within 200 milliseconds, you would feel something called hot cognition, basically prejudgment of the topic. You've already evaluated your feelings on this and thus have an opinion, even without thinking about it. And that hot cognition and your emotions are then tainting how you feel about any evidence that I'm giving you. For example, if you've been told humans cause climate change, and you believe that climate change equals regulation, and that regulation is bad, then because of hot cognition, climate change equals bad. It only takes milliseconds for this to occur, and it's one of the first steps in forming an opinion. But it's also super important, because every memory, every thought, and everything afterward can be tainted by that hot cognition opinion. The psychologists who published this paper think the reason that people don't believe the evidence is because we prejudge everything with our emotions. And it's not just politics that can cause this. Sad music, attraction to the person who is speaking, or, you know, the opposite, even the weather can affect your true feelings on pretty much everything. But that's just one model out of many different communication theories. Emotions do affect everything we do, but we can fight that natural tendency to react emotionally to evidence by thinking. It's simple, but it's pretty powerful. The problem is, that takes energy and effort. Humans have a natural tendency, according to early 20th century social psychologist Kurt Lewin, to resist change. Thinking is hard. He says we like the status quo and our inherent opinion because we value the groups we belong to now. Change means inviting discomfort into our social reality. It's so much easier to say, I don't believe you, you're challenging my status quo or my default or my social reality, depending on the model. And even though I've never read anything on what you're talking about, I feel it's bad and will fight not to expend energy to think about it. The moral of this story, as I see it, based on this research, is people don't believe in science because it requires we think, we evaluate, and we reevaluate, and all of those things are hard. At times, science does feel unnatural. It asks us to question and be skeptical and to debate as objectively as possible. All things that we don't naturally do very well. It's a skill we can learn if cultivated and encouraged, though. So, knowing this, if you do want someone to believe your evidence, don't appeal to their emotions, if you can. Appeal instead to their curiosity. Avoid presenting evidence that will trigger joy or anger or fear or disgust. Instead, trigger their thinking caps, their cognition. And if I haven't convinced you with any of this, maybe rewatch this video. If you like thinking about how we think about things, check out this video on our Seeker Daily sister show about an ancient Greek dude who says we all know nothing, even if we think we know stuff. Let us know why you don't believe the evidence in the comments, and please subscribe for more DNews.